G'day guys, it's Kieran from Solartech here. In this video I just want to give you a bit of an overview of Pack & Go and some of its functionality. So you can see here what I've got is a nice little assembly. I've got all my file names with project numbers appended to the front and a revision at the end. And let's say I want to duplicate this to a new project name or project folder so that I can change some of the dimensions, which is something that you generally want to do with your project so you don't have to model everything from scratch. So I'm just going to go File, Pack and Go. This brings up the Pack and Go dialog box. And you can see here we're in the nested view, so we've got a nice overview of all of our files as they exist now, all the folders that they're in. And I'm just going to check that include drawings. Obviously, if you've got simulation results or PhotoView 360 appearances, you can check those boxes to include them as well. But I don't, so I'm just going to include the drawings. You can see it's picked up the drawings here. And if you take a look, you notice that I've actually got a subfolder for drawings, for at least some of my drawings here. So it will pick up drawing files even if they don't have the same name. So you can see here, I've got a subassembly. This one's called subassembly here, so it doesn't have the same name as any of the files, but it has picked it up anyway. So it will pick up drawings with different names and drawings in subfolders. It won't pick up any drawings outside of the main folder though, so in this case the main folder is our project folder here. So now that I've got all my files selected, I can pick the new folder that I'm going to save to. So in this case I've already created a new project folder, but you could just use the Make New Folder option. So you can see my Save To folder is now the new project folder. I do have the Flatten to Single Folder checkbox checked. So for example, these drawings which have been saved to the subfolder are now going to be saved into the main directory, the new main directory. So if I want to change that, it's very, very straightforward. You just double click in the Save To folder field for that particular file and you can just browse to the correct folder. And I just want to do that for this file here as well. And I might also do it for this main assembly drawing. Similarly, if you want to change any of the file names, you can. So in this case here, for say Universal Joint, just double click on the file name to bring this up and just shorten that to UJ. See, it's going to change it, and the great thing is it's going to keep all of its references to all of the other parts. Obviously I want to change the project name for all of these parts as well. To do it all individually just by double clicking would be a bit of a pain in the ass, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Select and Replace option. And I only recently discovered this button. So to the people who I've said this wasn't possible, I apologize. This is going to save you a lot of time if you do need to rename projects a lot and you use project numbers. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to search for a certain string of text. In this case it's going to be ST123456 7 in the Save To name. So you can see you can do this for folders, for Save To folders, and all these other fields as well if you like. So if you need to change the Save To folder you can. But in this case I'm just going to do Save To Name. So I'm going to search the Save To Name field in all of these files for this string. I want to replace the text with my new project name, which is XY 13987 65, and I can just say replace all and abracadabra. You can see it's replaced all of the text with the new project number. So you can see this is going to save you a whole bunch of time rather than having to rename everything manually, say using SolidWorks Explorer. The other thing I want to do is also remove that revision 01 at the end of all of the file names. So again, I'm just going to search for Rev01 And if I leave this completely blank, it's exactly the same as deleting the text. So in fact, I want to get rid of the underscore there as well. So I'm just going to do all of that at once. And then I can say replace all. And you can see it's now removed that rev01 from all of the file names. So that's a nice quick way to rename everything. If you need to add any new prefixes or suffixes, you can check these boxes. Maybe I could change this. Let's say, call it rev06 or something like that. Whatever you like. You call it working, because I'm still working on this. If you did want to save it to a zip file, you could change that to save it to a zip file instead of a folder. So that's for easy emailing, which is nice as well. But once you're ready, you need to make sure you click Save. If you press Enter, you'll find it does close the dialog box without saving, so make sure you actually click the Save button. Just take a moment to save all those files. And here I've got my projects folder. If I open that up, you can see here I've got all of my new files, like so. I'll just close the old one and open the new one. And you can see that it's opened it up with all of the new references and everything intact. So that's Pack and Go at a glance. If you have any questions, feel free to comment on our blog. Cheers.